When he came, there was no light. When he left, there was no darkness. My prayer is that that simple statement would embody everything that you and I are doing for Christ in this great nation of the Philippines. Jesus in you. When my hands stretch out towards the sky.
You were once in darkness, but now you are the light in the Lord. Oh, Pastor, it's difficult. Yes, it is. Oh, Pastor, the vision is difficult. Yes, it is. Oh, Pastor, to disciple is difficult. Yes, it is. But difficult is not impossible.
¿Cuántas veces Dios nos enseña?
So many times God teaches us.
Lecciones grandes.
Big lessons.
Yo aprendí eso.
I learned.
No a mirar los discípulos.
Not to look at my disciples.
Por lo que ellos aparentan.
As for what they currently seem to be.
Yo los veo.
But I see them.
Por lo que ellos van a ser en
as
Dios.
For what they are going to become.
Are coming to this place because together we believe on a vision. We believe that this is our assignment as a church, that this nation will be changed and be transformed for the glory of our God. That is our assignment.
But I praise God for Pastor Cesar because he was not slow, but he was fast to understand that the best way to disciple people is not to be injecting the Word of God and preaching and preaching and preaching away. But the best way to disciple people is to model what the Bible says, to model being a disciple of Jesus. And when we model the lifestyle of Jesus, slow people like me become fast, because you turn your disciples who were once slow into fast people.
But this vision is not a program. This vision is about helping people who are living in darkness, even sometimes those that you call successful.
Cuando uno conoce a Jesús,
when you get to know Jesus,
uno conoce la luz.
You get to know the light.
No quiere volver las tinieblas.
And you never want to go back to darkness again.
Conocer a Jesús,
getting to know Jesus,
es la mejor experiencia.
Is the greatest experience that one could have.
Life is not an experiment because we live by faith.
We are the light. So when we go home, we are not just bringing the light with us. We are going to give it to the people around us.
We are hesitant to launch our ministry because we thought that God could not trust us. But let me remind you, God is counting on you faithful.
You have never wasted your life when you serve God in doing evangelism and discipleship. You are always doing what is right before God.
No place for the devil, not even for a second in your life.
When God will promote you, nobody can pull you down.
I'm glad I invested not on a thing. God allowed me to invest on people's lives.
We declare the promises of God over our nation, over Mindanao, Luzon, and Visayas. We declare the power of the blood of Jesus.
The light, an idea, a perspective, something that strikes you out of the ordinary would make you move and do something.
God sends someone, God always sends someone in your life to bring you to your impossible future.
El problema es,
the problem is,
Cuando un líder piensa,
when a leader begins to think
que el fruto es por causa de ellos,
that the fruit is because of them,
ahí todo lo echa a perder.
That's the end.
Pero cuando el líder se apoya en Dios,
but when a leader learns to lean on God,
y Dios ocupa siempre el primer lugar,
and God is number one in all things,
no hay peligro de que esa persona cambie.
There is no way that person is going to be corrupted.
Wherever you go, you can just call his name because that faith is birthed in your heart. And because of your labor of love, that love motivates you to serve the Lord.
Because light is symbolizes an answer, a solution. So when Jesus calls the believer today, regardless of where you've traveled from, regardless of who you are, young in age or mature in age or skilled in talents and abilities, I want you to understand how God sees you. He says, you are the light of the world. In other words, you are a solution. You are an answer.
Shine a light, shine a light. Shine a light, shine a light. Shine a light, shine a light. Shine a light, shine a light.
Favor is what we need. Can you believe that? Don't just conceive the vision. Believe that because of the favor of God, you can fulfill your God-given assignment.
He wants us to start shining and ignite a flame in someone else's life. And if you and that person begin igniting other lives, it's going to shine until the day is perfect.
Come on, shout for victory!